gone to every practical and toot. You've done the lecture quizzes on Kahoot. You've learnt a lot of stuff, hopefully enough. But please don't let complacency take root. I'd love to give you all HDs, although I can't give marks away for free, and so listen to this song till you can sing along with all the topics that you need to know. Sometimes you're never gonna find out everything about the population that your question is about. So work out statistics after representative sampling and estimate parameters or test your theory out. Always let the research question be your guide. Like if you just need to describe a population, see what insights histograms and box plots can provide. Or work out median, mean, and standard deviation. Each statistic from the sample lets you estimate the unknown parameter in the population. With the standard error tables, you can calculate an interval probably surrounding its location. If instead the research question is a yes or no, you can answer that with a hypothesis test that says how weird the sample looks if we assume HO. But which one should you use? Which test is best? There are 8 tests that we've done in Stat170. First the population mean, 1 sample T. Tests if mu is mu naught, use it when you don't know. Mu or sigma, which happens frequently. Sometimes you're never gonna find out everything about the population that your question is about. So work out statistics after representative sampling and estimate parameters or test your theory out. The z-test population mean is just the same, but used when somehow you know sigma but not mu. Those tests are fine if only one mean figures in the claim. What if rather than a single sample you've got two? Well, do the observations pair up naturally in twos? Is one in A connected to one in B behind the scenes? You can then subtract to get a single list and use the paired t-test for equal population means. Otherwise, you should use the 2-sample T and pool the variances to find the test statistic. It's complicated, but it's on the sheet of formulae. 'Cause I may be demanding, but I'm not sadistic. If a population proportion is the thing at stake, there's a Z-test that compares P and Pinehart. It's an easy test. It's a piece of cake, and if it's positive, then P's not what you thought. Sometimes you're never gonna find out everything about the population that your question is about. So work out statistics after representative sampling and estimate parameters or test your theory out. Rather than numeric or dichotomous, if the variable of interest is categorical, then a chi-square test is needed to enlighten us and compare hypothetical proportions with empirical. Are the population proportions what people say? Answer that with the chi-squared goodness of fit. Does one variable influence another in some way? Use the independence test, don't make a mess of it. The last test that we studied tries to verify that the slope of a regression line isn't flat. In that case, you can use X to help predict Y, but you've got to check assumptions before you do that. Just make sure the trend is linear instead of curved. If the residuals are skewed, it's not too drastic. And if there's places where a wider spread can be observed, then I'm sorry, but your dad is heteroskedastic. Sometimes you're never gonna find out everything about the population that your question is about. So work out statistics after representative sampling and estimate parameters or test your theory out. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. And if there's any questions, let me know. You've been real nice to teach, and so I wish you each the best of luck in Stat 170.